want that. I have said that before. Maybe I need to put it on a t-shirt. I'm too old to go to the disco. Not specifically, but basically the fact that I want to be in bed at 9 o'clock, you know? So, I need cement. You know? My lovely nestlings, and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45, from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today is another episode in my makeup 101 for mature skin. I will leave the playlist in the description box and at the end screen. Today's topic is primers, and I was like, what can I talk to you guys about primers? Because primers is pretty personal. Is it necessary? Not really. Well, it could be. It all depends on what you expect from a primer and what primer you pick. But I thought, you know what? I actually think that it can benefit some of you. So, hence the fact that the primer episode is still in here. What I have on the face, I filmed a foundation review with the foundation that I have on my face now, which is the Catrice True Skin. And I also filmed the makeup look. When both will be online, I don't know. I think I scheduled the foundation review for this week, but I'm not exactly sure. My schedule is downstairs, just so you know. But yeah, today, primers. Primers. What can I... Let's start with, do you need a primer? Not specifically. So yeah, a primer can help. It kind of depends on what you want in your primer. Now, first you are looking at your face. What does your face need? What do you want out of a primer? Do you want a primer that maybe is a little bit more of a glowy primer? Do you want an oil primer? Do you want hydration? Do you want mattifying? Do you want pore blurring? What do you want in a primer? But that's not all. That is basically the first step. The second step is, what's the foundation that you want to use with it? Because for me personally, there are foundations that I use with different primers. So for instance, a very matte foundation, I don't want to use with a matte primer. If I have a mattifying foundation, a lot of the time I want a little bit more glow, a tiny bit more glow. So I either use a glowier primer underneath, or maybe I mix it in even, or I use, for instance, one of these, you know, the Hydro Grip, but also the Catrice Hydro Primer, because they give the foundation a little bit more glow, so I don't have that mask effect. On the other hand, if I'm, for instance, using my Revolution Pro CC Cream, which is a little bit more of a dewier foundation in and of itself, I like a primer underneath that is, for instance, this, the Angel Feel Primer from NYX, because it's a little bit more mattifying almost. So that is how I play with the finish of the foundation and the primer that I want to use. The other thing that you kind of need to look for is texture. If you have a primer that is very silicony and you have a foundation that is water-based, it will clash, and vice versa. So that is also something that you need to see. If you feel like your primer or your foundation is spilling, look at the layers that you have beneath. For me, a lot of the time, I know, because I have checked, I have no water foundations here. Yes, there is always water in a, or usually water in a foundation, but still, they also are pretty silicony. That is why they work well with the primers that I have. And the other way as well, even these Hydra primers have silicon in them to help against that pilling effect. Okay, if you feel like you do have pilling, what helps for me, I have here a spray bottle with some water in it. I basically spray my face and then I gently almost emulsify it again. Because sometimes it is the fact that it is, I don't know, that it doesn't have enough moisture. That's how I feel, at least. So that is it for me. So yeah, what can you kind of take away from this then is, first off, do you need a primer? What do you want from your primer? Go look at that, and then kind of see, okay, how does it behave with the foundation that I want to use? If you want a very, very matte face, you don't go put a glowy primer underneath your foundation, because that then, even if you are using a full coverage matte foundation, it gives you a little bit more glow. And if that is what you want, that is a very nice way. So for the glowier, let me kind of show you what I have here. Let me grab all my primers, because yes, I have a bunch of primers. Okay. Also, texture. If you have a very dry skin, it could be that you want a texture that is a little bit more emollient, a little bit more like a cream almost, you know, like a moisturizer. If you have a very oily skin, I imagine that you want something that's a little bit thinner. You know, I kind of want a little bit more in between because I have my skincare, so I don't want a primer that feels like a moisturizer because I already have a moisturizer on my face. So I either go for something that is very lightweight because, again, also light layers, especially if you are mature, light thin layers are better than thick, thick gloopy layers because of the texture that we have, because of everything that moves. And, you know, if you have heavy layers on your face, this happens. And we don't want that. I have said that before. Maybe I need to put it on a t-shirt. Stuff hangs then, like the boobies. Never mind. But yeah, so I have primer oils here. Primer oils I actually really like. I have two different ones. This one is from e.l.f., which is a little bit more of a thicker, richer one. And here I have one from MUA. This is a primer oil with tea tree oil. And this is a very thin, almost a drier oil. When do I use those? When I feel like it. That's it. If I feel like my face is a little bit dry, I can use these. But usually I go for a primer oil underneath a foundation that is... I can actually try it with the foundation that I have now. But for instance, the Catrice HD foundation, which is a more mattifying foundation, I really like to use with an oil. Because I find that gives a very pretty finish and they work very well together. Do these give me a certain glow? Yeah, not necessarily, I feel at least. I do have glowy primers though. So for instance, this one from Be Your Own Desire, illuminating primer. This is a very, very thin consistency and it gives a nice glow without making me look like a disco ball. It's very thin, it's a very light texture. Especially underneath a mattifying foundation. I think it is very, very pretty. You could even use it underneath a glowy foundation if you want to. I just don't like that. Because I feel that if I have a glowy foundation on, every texture that I have in my face is emphasized. And I don't really go for that. I don't want to be like a vampire in the sun or like a disco ball. I'm too old to go to the disco. Not specifically, but basically the fact that I want to be in bed at 9 o'clock, you know? So... that's what I mean. So yeah, so I have that one. I also have one from Catrice. This is the 10-in-1, which is also more of a glowy one. This is a little bit of a thicker consistency. I like to mix this in with a foundation. But I also like to use it on its own. I don't use it a lot right now, but I do like it. A thin layer, usually in winter, because then my face is a little bit drier, you know. Then the other glowy foundations that I have are actually these, but these are also my gripping foundations. Let's start with this one. This is the newest to my collection. This is the Catrice Hydro Primer Love Skin and Respect Earth. It is available in Europe, but not in the USA, at least not now. This is a little bit more of almost a hybrid between basically... this one, texture wise, that's what I mean. So texture of this or of the angel veil, for instance, so a little bit more of a cream, and the texture of a gel. So this is like a gel, but not as sticky, and it is a little bit more creamy than a gel. I don't really know how to explain it. If you want grip, but you don't want very, very sticky primer, this could be something for you if you can find it. It will probably come to the USA. I don't know when. It is a new release. But I like it. It grips my makeup, especially now in winter. I think though that if I am in summer and my face is very sweaty, I will try it. But I think it is not... I think then it is for me a little bit too emollient, a little bit too thick perhaps. And not grippy enough. But I'm not sure, because we're not in summer right now. So I don't know, but I do like it. And it is, again, a little bit of a hybrid between a very grippy gel primer and a normal hydrating primer. It's a very nice in-between. Then the two that I have here, which are the same. It's the Milk Makeup Hydro Grip and the X Revolution Hydra Fix. They are the same, guys. They just are. I have done a video comparing the two. One side, one primer. The other side, the other primer. I could not tell a difference unless I looked with my 5x magnifying mirror very, very close. And then you can kind of see that this is a little bit more expensive. But who is that close? So if you want to try the Milk Makeup Hydro Primer, but you either find it way too expensive, because it is expensive, or you cannot get a hold of it, try this one from X Revolution, the Hydra Fix, because it is a lot cheaper and works just as well. The ingredients are a little bit different, but from what it does and what I want of it, I can go either way. So basically, they grip my makeup, they lock it into place, they give me hydration and glow. That is what these do for me. And the texture, it's a gel texture, it's very thin, it sinks in. I like it. I like those primers a lot. Oh, I forgot a hydrating primer from Essence. I do like the consistency of this primer a lot, the hydrating and perfecting primer. I just detest the dispenser because it doesn't work for me. So that is why I haven't used it a ton. I wish this came in a pump system or in something like this, because I think it is a very nice primer. This is actually the closest I have come to the Fenty one in a drugstore option. But I haven't used it a ton because of the dispense thing. What else do I have here? This is, what are you? You are a perfect filter face primer. Yeah, so I have here from AOA. This also reminds me a little bit of the Fenty one. I like the Fenty one better though, because it just, it does more, and it should, because it's way more expensive. This is a nice primer for when I just want to have a nice primer underneath. Maybe to, if I feel like my skincare could peel a little bit, sometimes that happens, that I messed up my skincare a little bit, or the layers up a little bit, then this is a very nice primer to put over top. If you just want an extra layer, maybe a little bit more hydration, or you just like the feel of a primer, this is very nice. For me, I don't think it does anything extra for what I want, which is basically the extra hydration and the tackiness, and it doesn't blur. So for me, this does not do enough, but it is nice. If you are, I don't know, 10 years younger than me, then yeah, maybe it does blur for you. I need cement, you know. So yeah, also the putty primers, no, they're not for me. Not for me. What else? Because these two are blurry ones as well, but in a different way. So let's go to the blurry ones. So I have two blurry ones here. I have this one. This was a gift, actually. The MUA Pro Base Smooth Set and Prime Blur Stick. It's not bad. I do see it blur here a little bit. And I actually like this one. I also tried the e.l.f. Putty Primer. I am not a fan at all. It does not do anything for me besides being very, very heavy on my face. This I do really like. Does it blur a lot? More than I thought it would, actually. And then I kind of use it here. And I can... Who am I kidding? I use it everywhere because that is who I am. But I concentrate this primer. I concentrate here. And here, where I have basically the most pores. And I could put it here, but it does not do a lot. But I do really like the texture. It has a little bit of a powdery thing in it. And it blurs a tiny bit. So it kind of does blur, which for me is a big thing. Because usually they do not. So it does blur a bit, but it doesn't feel heavy on my skin. I like it. When will I grab this? I grab this on days where I feel like my pores are overly large. And I want, for instance, my Revolution CC cream, which is a little bit more of a dewier foundation. Then it is something that I grab this for, in that combination. So with a dewier foundation, I grab a blurring primer. Or this one that I have on my face now, the NYX Angel Veil. When I put this one on, I can see it kind of mattifies a little bit. And that way it blurs. Does that make any sense? I kind of hope so. It plays very nicely underneath the foundation that I have now. It does not make it any drier. It's a nice primer. Skin perfecting primer. Yeah, for as far as the primer can perfect my skin, it does its job. It feels nice. It doesn't feel very silicony, because sometimes, especially blurring primers, can feel very, very silicony. This one does not. I like it. I do. Do you need it? Yeah, probably not. Yeah, velvety primer. Yeah, that's basically the feeling that it gives me. A kind of a velvety feel. So yeah, so in that it works. It's a nice thinner consistency. I use this one with, for instance, a glowier foundation. Or this. What I have on now, because I kind of want to try it. And this, the True Skin, is also a little bit more of a mattifying foundation, which I keep forgetting, because it's also a hydrating foundation. And in my mind, hydrating foundations are always making me glow like a disco ball. But this one does not. But it works very well underneath a mattifying foundation as well. So yeah, if you are oily, maybe you will like this, because it has a little bit of a powderiness to it almost. Then the last two that I will mention are, for me, the most, almost the most blurring I feel. And those are two tinted primers. I have two. I have one from Essence and I have one from Catrice. Let's start with the one from Essence, which is the newest one. They have this in three colors, and this is the shade 20 Nude Beige. Instant Blur Effect Natural Matte Finish. Yes, that is what these do. They do blur and they do mattify. And because of the base tint that is in there, it almost does it a little bit. It evens out the skin tone a little bit as well. Yes. I also have this one from Catrice, the one in a pot. This one I have had the longest. This is, I think, pot number 3. Because I do really, really like this one. I like this one more than this one. I think this one is better than this one. This is more of a mousse and this is more of a cream almost. I just think that this one is better, guys. I don't know. Magic Finish Effect. Yeah, I used to use this with a brush. This is what it looks like. It's only one shade. But even though I have an olive skin or olive undertone, it doesn't, when you look at it, it's like, oh, but it's orange. But it doesn't give me that when I put it on the face. It's actually quite pretty when I put it on. And I have used this underneath foundation. I always get a heart attack almost when I'm phoned on the phone. But yeah, I was talking about the Catrice primer. Out of these two, I recommend this one, because I think that this one works for me at least the best. I like the consistency. I like it. And I use this underneath a foundation with, for instance, a sheerer coverage. So the newest one from Essence that I have here as well, which is a lighter coverage. This is what I kind of like to use underneath, unless I have a very good skin day. For today, I did not have a lot of redness in my face, so then I don't really need it. But on the days that I do have some more redness on my face, but I want that extra grip that foundation can give me, this is the one that I use underneath. And I like it more than this one from Essence. But yeah, because of the tint that it has, it is basically kind of something like this, the NYX Angel feel, but then a little bit more on steroids for me, because of the base shade that it also has. So it blurs even more. I used this one on its own as well, especially in summer, because then I'm like, it's too hot to bother. And then I don't know, I kind of want to look a little bit put together. I should just stick to doing my brows and sunscreen. But yeah, sometimes I want to be extra fancy. But yeah, so what can you take away from this primer video? Look for, if you want to use a primer, let's start with, do you need a primer? No, you do not. But if you do want to use a primer, look for a primer that does what you want it to do. So first you kind of need to know, what do you want your primer to do? Do you want your primer to color correct maybe? Do you want your primer to even out your skin tone? Do you want it to blur? Do you have, like I have especially in summer, that you feel like your foundation is sliding around? So do you want that extra grip? What do you want in a primer? Or do you want hydration? Or do you just want a primer because you feel like you want a primer? Then go for something like this, which is very cheap and feels like a primer. Does it make my makeup last longer? I have no idea. I do feel though that the primers that I have here, especially the ones that grip, the gel primers, do make my makeup last longer. For the rest, yeah, not so much. I'm not gonna lie. Yeah. And then, if you know what you want out of your primer, look how it reacts or relates to your foundation. So if you are like me and you don't want to glow like a disco ball, then don't use a glowy foundation with a glowy primer. because you're like a disco ball then. You could on strategic places if you want to. If you want extra glow here and here or here, you can put a glowy primer there and then your foundation on top, because no one says that you need to use one primer for your entire face, you know? So you could do that if you want to. Hell, you could even use a glowy primer, I think, at least on top. I don't know how much it will work, but maybe it will. I have never tried that. I'm just throwing something out there. How I start looking for what do I want to use on my face, unless I know the foundation that I'm going to use, I go backwards. So I look at the foundation. This is the foundation that I want to use. How is my skin feeling? It feels a little bit dry. Okay, I want a hydrating primer, but which one do I want? Do I want a hydrating primer that just gives me hydration? For instance, like this one, or like this one from Catrice, because this one does not give me an overly glow either. Or do I want something that has a little bit more glow? That is how I go and pair my foundation to my concealer, or no, to my primer, because I know that my primers and my foundations all play nice together. I think that's it. So basically, you heard me mention in this video how I think that it is logical to go about picking out a primer, and then in combination with the foundation, and then the primers that I have. I did not really want it to be about the specific primers, but I do know that some of you will want to know. Yeah, I think that's it. I hope it was helpful. Let me know if it was helpful. Did I answer your questions? Maybe I even gave you more questions. Let me know down below in the comment section. I will link or at least list the ones that I mentioned today in the description box. And I will try to kind of group them together a little bit. You know, the gripping primers and then the glowy primers and all that. I don't know if I can though, because I'm going all over the place as per usual. But yeah, it is the way that it is. This was it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to go to the side to give a special thank you to my members that you will see scrolling on the screen right now. If you want to become a member, there is a link to join in the description box. And there's also a link to the merch Teespring shop if you want to browse there. I will leave my Makeup 101 for Mature Skin playlist underneath the cards. No, at the end screen, and it is also in the description box. Before you leave, don't forget to hit the subscribe button if you haven't done so already, of course, because this is for now at least a series on my channel. And I would like to take you along for the ride. Also, most of you are probably getting sick of me saying this, but I also recently found out that I have an olive undertone, so I'm light olive. If you want to accompany me on that journey, trying new foundations and probably going to go through my blush collection pretty soon as well to see what will work and what does not work anymore, then make sure that you have hit the subscribe button. If you are a greenie like me and you have tips and tricks, please cruelty-free ones though, let me know down below as well. And then this is it for today's video. Yes, I'm going to go. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. Yeah, and I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.